We've all been there, that moment right before we have to get up and give a presentation. Your heart beats faster, your hands get clammy, and you start to shake and you hope like crazy that you won't forget everything you've prepared to say. But then when it's all said and done, the presentation doesn't go too bad.
So I'm here to talk to you guys today about...
So how about your high schooler? Are they comfortable making a presentation?
The skill of oral presentation is really important for students because they're going to be using it for the rest of their lives in many different contexts.
Today in the age of selfies and YouTube, you'd think it would be easier for kids to make presentations, but not always. Kids need to put a lot of prep work into their presentations. First of all, they need to really know their topic. They'll do research and think about what points are important to cover. A good presentation has a flow that makes sense with all the information clearly organized. Lots of kids struggle with this part. A little help at first will get them going.
My teacher, she actually gave me a suggestion how I should do my presentation. So she said, okay, introduction's the first thing. Then you're gonna go more in depth with the story. And then at the end is gonna be the conclusion.
Others have figured out their own strategy to get organized.
I like to outline the topics first, and then I go back and put in the details.
Second, a strong presentation has good nonverbal communication. Some kids will need a lot of work on this. They'll need to practice good eye contact, body language, and posture, as well as avoiding ums and other distracting mannerisms.
Some interesting facts is that,
try not to say
Yeah, I've been trying to work on that. So some interesting facts is that East Palo Alto is becoming the only affordable city.
Now she's got it. Finally, a good presentation uses media elements effectively. They'll gather photos, video, and other graphics to help make their point and to make it more interesting for their audience.
For my research question, I chose this picture because there's people protesting and they have different banners.
So what can you do to help your kids avoid the pre-presentation terror you remember? Help them practice.
Have them practice at least once in front of them. And if the parent can understand the main point of the student's presentation, that's an amazing place to start.
So ask your high schooler to practice her next presentation in front of you. And look for a presentation that has well-researched and clearly organized information, has good nonverbal communication, and incorporates media effectively.